Hello, my name is Mykola Kolesnik and I'm working on bringing you to the automated UI testing in Android video course by Pug Publishing. Before we start, let's introduce the author who prepared all the materials for this course. Mykola Kolesnik is a software test automation engineer with more than 12 years of experience. During the practice, he operated with many different technologies including Java, C#, Ruby, Script and many other customized solutions. He is actively participating in technical review for Pug Publishing books. Let's get started. This video will lead you through all sections and major items we need to cover to gain consistent practical knowledge of how to use and how to perform automation for Android. The entire course is split into 7 sections. On the first section, we'll make a basic overview of existing engines and perform initial setup for devices, solution, and generally environment. On section 2, we'll start writing sample tests. We'll create some simple plain scenario and then start adding improvements. On section 3, we'll start wrapping controls and pages with class abstractions. We'll create wrappers separately for pages and controls. Then we'll implement page factory. On section 4, we'll take a look at complex cases for pages and elements. In this section, we will implement functionality which makes our test compatible both with mobile applications and web applications. We'll apply various interactions with sub-elements. Then we'll implement scrolling and we'll play around additional functionality which would be in use. On section 5, we'll take a look at Android-specific actions. In particular, we'll take a look at actions which control application step, start-stop applications. Also, we'll take a look at more specific things like deep linking, killing application process in background, upgrade scenarios. On section 6, we'll exercise various data collection. In this section, we will show how to collect error stack trace, activity launch time, or processor workload, memory use. In section 7, we'll take a look at more high-level updates to entire solution, which helps us with using different framework types, integrating with the CI systems, and in the end, we'll make some overview of the entire course. In order to get comfortable with this course, the people need to have at least basic Java programming knowledge and basic object-oriented programming concept understanding. Most of the examples will be based on real practice, so having the above knowledge should be enough to at least get an idea of what is going on. So let's get started with this learning, and I hope you'll enjoy it.